Hello friends, today we will see another implementation of divide and conquer technique, that is Strassen's matrix multiplication. Matrix multiplication has always been important for larger mathematical calculations. As we do a regular matrix multiplication of multiplying the rows and columns and adding, and if there is a large number of matrix size, then it becomes really difficult to add up to it. So we see another divide and conquer strategy of Strassen's matrix multiplication. If I have a matrix which is given here as A, B, C, D, F elements and E, F, G, H, and if I need to multiply them, what do I get? In the regular matrix multiplication, we get A into E plus B into G, A into F plus B into G, C into E plus D into G, and C into F plus D into H. We have 8 products and 4 sums. As the size of my matrix increases, this is a 2x2 matrix. So if the size of my matrix increases, you can assume how many products and sums will be there to solve that particular matrix multiplication. And it really becomes tedious to solve the larger matrix multiplication problem. The general algorithm's time complexity is O n raised to the power of 3. This is a regular matrix multiplication without using a Strassen's matrix multiplication. So what comes into picture is a faster way using the divide and conquer technique to solve this matrix multiplication easily. So what we do, we see a Strassen's matrix multiplication. This algorithm is named after Volker Strassen and is an algorithm, as we've discussed, for matrix multiplication. It is faster than the standard matrix multiplication algorithm, useful in practice for large matrix, but would be slower than the fastest known algorithm for extremely large matrix. These are worked out for a middle size matrix where the multiplication can be done in a faster way. Now we see how this matrix multiplication takes place. We take the same example as we took it for the regular matrix. I have 2 matrix of the size 2x2. We find in this particular matrix multiplication technique that rather than having a simple matrix multiplication, we divide it into different points. Those are termed from P1 to P7. If you see a P1, P2, P3 and P4. It is termed with A into F minus H, H into A plus B, E into A plus D and D into G minus A. It is very difficult to remember this particular formula. So what we do is we write P1, P2, P3, P4 and then as we write P1, P2, P3 and P4, here is a small shortcut which is developed for you to remember how the particular multiplication takes place. Just remember the word ahead, A-H-E-D, not A-H-E-A-D. We remember it as A-H-E-D. And we write those alphabets in front of P1, P2, P3 and P4. We make sure that when we are working with rows, they are added, and when we are working with columns, they are subtracted. That is, in case of P1, if it is 2 matrix, that is A, B, C, D and E, F, G, H, which will be named as X and Y for our understanding, we say from X we take the value A, and on the Y side of the matrix, that is from E, F, G, H, I take the last column, that is F and H, as that is a column, so it will be F minus H. So my P1 will get the value A multiplied by F minus H. Now when I go to P2, the value P2 is calculated as H into. We've taken the last element of the value matrix Y, and I take the first row of the matrix X, so it will be H into A plus B. So we have to always remember that when we are working on columns, we will do subtraction, and when we are working on rows, we will do addition. So we've got the values of P1 and P2. For P3, we have the value E that we've written from ahead, and then value E comes from my second matrix. So you will see that in P2, we added the rows A plus B. In the second case, that is in P3, we'll add up the rows C plus D. So just remember one thing, P2 and P3 will work on the rows of the matrix X. So it will be easy for you to remember that P2 and P3 work on matrix X rows, and P1 and P4 work on the matrix Y columns. So we've got P1, P2, P3. Now we'll see what happens with P4. P4, D we have written, and then we will write G minus E as we work on the column. So we've got the four values of the strands matrix multiplication. Now what to do with P5? P5 works on the diagonal columns. So it is P5 works on the diagonal, so it is A plus D into E plus H, the two diagonals from both the matrices. And now P6 is found out by the columns, as P5 we observed is for the rows and P6 for the columns. So in P6 we have B minus D into F minus H. And the last one, that is P7, is A minus C into E plus F. An easier technique to remember P1 to P7 is we first write down AHED for P1, P2, P3 and P4. And then for A, we do, that is for the columns of the second. For P2, we do the first row. For P3, we do the second row of the first matrix. And for P4, we do the first column of the second matrix. And for P5, it works on the diagonals. P6 works on the second columns. And P7 works on the first column and the first row. This is a technique which we have to remember while we are working on this particular strands matrix multiplication. This is a technique which will be used again and again when you're using this multiplication technique. Now strands matrix multiplication works on, we found out P1 to P7. Now what do we do with this P1 to P7? It does not give us the solved answer. That is, we have divided it. The particular matrix multiplication has now been divided into P1 to P7. But we are still to conquer the solution. So how do we conquer? The four matrix that we get over here for the matrix size, for the four rows and the columns that we get over here is, for X and Y, we get the resultant as Z. The first one which comes out to be, that is at a location 1, 1, we say it works on the even numbers. And the even number works in such way, even numbers, that is for the even numbers P1 to P7. We say it is P6 plus P5 plus P4 minus P2. And for the second one, it is P1 plus P2. That is for the first row, second column, it is P1 plus P2. And for the second row, first column, it is P3 plus P4. And the last one, that is 2 by 2, the second row, second column, works on the odd numbers. This is just a strategy which is developed for us to remember. And the strands matrix multiplication follows this P1 to P7, that is whatever the results we get in the divide and conquer strategy to simplify the larger matrix multiplication. So if you observe this particular matrix Z, what you get is the first row first column works on the even numbers, The first row, second column works on P1, P2, and the second row, first column works on P3, P4, and the 2x2, that is second row, second column works on the odd numbers, which is P1 plus P5 minus P3 minus P7. And for this particular matrix, Strassen matrix multiplication, the algorithm takes a little less than the complexity of the regular matrix, that is O n raised to the power of 2.80. The regular matrix, as we've seen, without using the divide and conquer techniques, which has 8 products and 4 sums, has O n raised to the power of 3. Here we've tried to reduce a little complexity using the Strassen matrix multiplication, and this is the best multiplication technique for the larger matrix multiplications. Thank you.